Hello, 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 hello. It's me again, Patrick Steven, coming to you again on our channel. Thank you so much again for joining me today. I believe we're going to have an awesome time. Today we want to talk about the power of dreams. Dreams are so important for our life, our success, and our fulfillment. I want to begin by making some very, very powerful statements made by very successful people. One of them was Helen Keller. She said this lady was born blind, she was born deaf with so many disabilities, but she ended up writing so many books and achieving so much in her lifetime. She once said, somebody asked her, what is worse than being blind? She said, it's having sight but having no vision. Do you know the Bible says in the book of Proverbs 29 verse 18, it says, where there is no vision, the people perish. One translation says they cast off restraint, meaning that when you don't have vision, you will waste time, you waste resources, you waste passion. Your life will have no meaning. Life will be boring. Life will just be like a routine. You know, you just go in a circle. You'll not be able to make progress. That's why we are talking about dreams. It's important to have dreams. And in this context, let me define what I mean by dreams. Dreams are mental picture of a preferable future. When you have a revelation, a mental picture of a better life, a better you, a greater you. I'm talking about the pictures that you have in your spirit and in your mind. So if I ask you the question, where do you see yourself in 10 years or in 5 years? Can I answer that? Where you are exactly in your dream today. So when the Bible says that where there is no vision, the people perish. Somebody once said, the poorest man in the world is not the man without a cent, but the man who has no vision. Another man once said, a wise man, he says, a man without a dream is not fit to live. Think about it. Dreamers rule the world. So the ability to dream is one of the greatest power that God ever gave to man. Think about it. Animals have no capacity to dream. As powerful as the lion is, the elephant, they cannot dream. And that's why they stay in the same habitat. They cannot actually create a better world out there. They've always remained where they've always been. Birds cannot dream. The fish cannot dream. In fact, there's no even record in the Bible that angels can dream. We are the only ones God has given us this capacity, this ability to be able to dream. Now think about it. In your physical body, you are limited. So for instance, by space and by time. So for instance, I am here right now recording this visit or talking to you. I can only be limited here. I cannot be here and be in America at the same time because we are limited by space physically. Think about time. I cannot live in 200 years ago or 100 years from now or 5 months from now. But you know that in my imagination, I can go forward 200 and replay things, stories I've read about. You also know I can go forward in my imagination because my imagination is not limited. So dreams help us to be able to escape our current reality and create the better world that we want out there. So if you ask me what are the ingredients you will use in building the future and building your tomorrow, is your thoughts. And that is why this is so important. I want you to understand right now, everything man ever created in this world was created twice. It was first created mentally before it is created physically. Think about the telephone, think about the car, think about the house, the clothes you're wearing, your wristwatch, your TV, your radio. Everything we use today was once an idea or a dream in somebody's mind before it became a reality. Think about the fact that if all of those things we enjoy today were not dreams in people's mind, what kind of a world do you think we're going to be living? Do you know that dreamers are the ones who make the world better? That is why they say dreamers rule the world. So you and I need dreams in our life, vision in our life. Because like Proverbs says, where there is no vision, the people perish. Do you know the Bible also tells us in Genesis 11 that when men came together in that day and they decided to build a tower that will reach to the heaven, when God looked down and saw what they were doing, God saw what they already built in their imagination. The only way God could stop it was to actually put the vision in their language. That means right now, where you are, if you understand the power of your thoughts and your mind, you have the ability to create a better future, a better you, a greater you. And I know right now that everyone listening to me, it doesn't matter where you find yourself, how limited you think you are. If you can begin to capture images and pictures in your spirit, those dreams and images will transport you from where you are with a bit of hard work and other principles to apply, will take you to a better future that you really desire to live in. So let's begin to talk about some essentials about dream. Because the first thing you have to understand is that once you capture a dream, dreams will make you uncomfortable. Now, if you have a dream and your dream looks like your current reality in your dream, it is a nightmare. Because once you have a dream, you become so dissatisfied with the status quo. Regardless of how life has been, how wonderful or how crazy it has been, you can see a better life, a better future that will inspire you. So one thing you need to understand in our discussion today is that whatever you want the next 10 years, the next 5 years, the next 5 months to be for you, today you need to begin to have the dream for it. So if you ask me, where do I see myself in 5 years or in 10 years? Exactly where you are today in your dream. Because the Bible says in Proverbs 23 and verse 7, it says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. I want you to think about that. It's an unbreakable law. This is not a law that we created as men. This is a law that we made. It's a fixed law. Where you are today is a result of the dreams you had or didn't have yesterday. And where you will be tomorrow also will actually be a product of the dreams that you have today or didn't have. And that is why one of the worst things that you can do to anybody is to oppress them to the point where they stop dreaming. One of the worst things that can happen to you is for a situation where a person to steal your dream from you. Think about when we are growing up, how much you see kids, the lofty dreams we have about life. You can survive anything when you have a dream. I was thinking about Nelson Mandela, how he was able to survive 27 years in prison. What kept him alive? What kept him going? Because dreams have a way of keeping us alive. They give you hope, even in a hopeless situation. Think about what he went through, Robben Island and the treatment and so on. You were dealing with the whole system of apartheid, but he kept saying, I see a better South Africa. And as a result, he was able to survive 27 years of imprisonment. People who have no dream, it's easy for them to give up. You quit after a setback. Don't allow the COVID-19 or what is happening right now to rob you of that ability to dream. I want you to know that your best days are still ahead of you, regardless of what your experience is right now. So I want to tell you, dreams are so powerful that you and I need to begin to capture your dream. Because if we have no dream, your future is sunk. If you have no dream, your future is doomed. You will go in every direction. Life will become so meaningless. You will have no purpose. You will have no direction until you begin to have dreams of tomorrow. And somebody said, what does it take to dream? It doesn't take anything. It just means you have to sit down and dream. And please, in your dream, don't be limited. You don't have to pay anything to dream. Just from where you are, you can begin to dream bigger dreams. And I want you to know that bigger dreams will attract the resources, the help. Do you know dreamers are attractive? Even people in the world who didn't start with any money, guess what? When they capture a dream, resources come, helpers come, and everything that they need. So I want to convince you today that dreams are so powerful. Even when you run into roadblocks, dreams have a way of making their way, or making a way for you to come out of those difficult situations. So if today you are limited financially, begin to capture a prosperous tomorrow. If right now you're living in a house you don't want, begin to see a better house. If right now you don't like the job you're doing, begin to see a better job. And let me tell you, it doesn't have to come by an angel or you sleeping in the night. You can sit down deliberately and consciously and begin to dream. It's a God-given ability. It's a God-given capacity. I don't know how to tell you how excited I am to know I'm not limited by space and time. Let me tell you, even after you're dead, your dream can outlive you. Do you know today democracy was once a dream and the ideology in the Greeks? If you go and read history where democracy came from, do you know right now most of the things we enjoy, the white brothers are not here, but today the world is still benefiting from their dream, even after they are dead. So you can only live for a particular time in history, but your dreams can be here for 300 years. You can do things today that will continue to bless the world even after you're gone. So I want to encourage you today that you need to sit down. Somebody said, I started the year, I had this particular dream, or when I was younger, and I feel right now that I'm not living the life that I wanted for myself. All you have to do is to sit down and start dreaming. And I'm going to come in other series to tell you how to understand what to do with dreams, you know, companions of dream, how to fight for your dream, how to feed and nurture your dream. And I think right now with what I've shared, I've encouraged and inspired you that right this moment, you can take some time, just sit down in the quietness of your room and then just begin to write your dream. Things you want to see. You don't know how it's going to work out. You don't know who will be part of it. But I want you to know something. Where there is no vision, the word vision there is dreams, the people perish. Guess what? Where there is vision, you will not perish. You will achieve, you will succeed, you will see progress, and you will see amazing things you never thought possible. And the world will be blessed that you are born at this time. God bless you. Thank you for listening to me. I see you in my next video with more content about this topic. God bless you.